Star Wars fans and our FlyGuy.net figure review. Now, we asked you on our Facebook page, facebook.com/FlyGuy.net, what figure you wanted to see out of the Clone Wars Han Solo, Endor, Revenge of the Sith, and Ponda Baba, and this was your number two choice, so this is what we're reviewing. This is a brand new figure, which those of you who've been fortunate enough to get the huge-ass cardboard Death Star, how you afforded it, I don't know, but massive cardboard Death Star, will be very familiar with this figure, because this is the one which comes inside the pack. Now, this figure has also been, and will be coming out in a carded version for Marx's Revenge of the Sith. Note the revenge, if you don't know what I mean about revenge, sorry, not Revenge of the Sith, Revenge of the Jedi. Have a bit of a Google around and you'll catch up. If you're a little bit too young from not knowing the kind of history of these movies, that'll get, maybe fill you in if you have a Google around, and I won't bore you with the reason why it was called Revenge and then changed to Return. But anyway, this figure inside this pack was available online at our favourite seller, Tung Hori, and I managed to pick this guy up. So there is no card to show you. Now, this is a repaint and a repack of an older figure which was available in a line literally 4 years ago, which was called the, roughly 4 years ago, which was called the Star Wars Vintage Original Trilogy Collection. That's the VOTC collection. And that figure that came out was this one. Now, it didn't come with a stand here, but it did come with this exact same body that we've got in this figure here. Now, all that's missing from this guy is his trench coat, which I've took off, which looked a little bit silly. So this figure here, the build, the waistcoat, which is removable, all the articulation, everything, the VOTC Han Solo, which is a very cool figure to this day, had kind of slightly muddy brown grey pants, and you'll see these yellow stripes up his leg, which is pretty movie accurate, and it's a great figure. So what Hasbro have done on this guy is they've repacked the exact same figure. What they have done though is change the head sculpt. Now, I actually quite like this head sculpt here. This is a classic one, and I think it really suits the figure and the size of the figure, which is the important point here, because this guy, it's just a little bit big. But anyway, that's the cape that he comes with, or the cape, the Endor coat. It's a little difficult to display on the figure, and it may be one that you want to take off, and I'm going to take that off here. And while we're doing so, we'll have a look at the blaster that Han Solo comes with. Now, standard blaster that comes on all of them, you can just about see that. Some really nice detail on the tip of the rifle with the chrome paint. In the past, Hasbro have avoided painting that and they've just given you it black, but it's nice to see that chrome's applied there because it just makes the figure look that little bit better. So that's the blaster. On with the rest of the figure. And as I've taken this cape off here, you'll see a little better underneath this guy. Now, he's a great figure. Again, the VOTC Han. It's a little weirdly proportioned. It tends to be a larger top-heavy body and very, very skinny legs. But if you pose the figure right, as I've done, as I mentioned previous, it can look really cool. But the head, what they've done here is the neck, if I take this head off, you'll see there's really a huge Adam's apple, very, very kind of pronounced. And it means that Han's chin here is a little bit harder to sit and the head won't go forward. And well, look, it's a little bit differently coloured, and like, we're getting really picky here for some fans out there, I know, but look, it's not a bad Han Solo, the likeness is good, but it's just the rest of the body seems a little bit of misproportion, but it's a great figure, and it's the best one we've had of Han Solo, I think, to date, in terms of the figure sculpt itself. Now, this working holster here looks a little bit odd, and it's just because the plastics are kind of, it needs a bit of a tie-in with one of those plastic tiebacks as I've done there, if you keep one of them. Now, I could take this off this figure, it's been on it literally for a year or so or longer, but if you take that off, the working horse will basically be held onto his leg a little better. It's just the way that it's made and it's fixed on, and it tends to kind of look a little stupid and bounce out. So if you tie that down, then you'll get an even better looking figure. So all in this articulation on this guy, well, he's got a ball jointed, excellently sculpted head, looking very like Han Solo, I have to say. Ball jointed shoulders, ball jointed elbows, and swivel wrists. He's also got a swivel waist. The waistcoat is removable. He's not got ball jointed hips. They are swivel hips, but ball jointed knees and awesome articulated ankles. So the only difference in this guy, you'll see, you can just almost see the ridge markings there on his trouser legs, and I think that may be a bit of a flaw they've done this time. because again the correct version has these kind of single lines there, so slight variance in that in the way that's been painted. And again, you'll see on the other side the yellow is incredibly strong this time, where actually in the movie it's a little bit more subtle, like this guy here. But look, it's a great figure, it's Han Solo. Gotta love the guy, fantastic figure overall. And again, Revenge of the Sith, you'll see this guy in carded versions, or as many of you do who follow our blog, we posted when this went up on sale at Tung Hori. So if you don't know what I mean, we'll put a link underneath the video to Tung Hori, or just have a search on our blog for the word Tung Hori and you'll find it links to the seller. So there we go, let us know what you think of this rather cool Han Solo, the Endor version, the Revenge of the Sith version, and let us know what you think. Collecting it, not collecting it, give us a shout, let us know, and we'll have another review coming up for you real soon. Cheers.